So today, what we will discuss three topics, very similar to high school, but with some modification: extrema, concavity, and maximum minimum. So now, let's go to the first topic. Relative local extrema. That one, like high school student. So I just recall, when you have function of one variable, so the graph of this function is one curve like this. And when you see this graph, you see somewhere you have fixed like highest point, somewhere you have valley bottom like lowest point. But this node on this or on valleys are the same. So for example, here you have one peak SC, but all the E higher and the highest E has. Similarly, you have valleys, you have bottom SB, but the lowest, this is G. So we distinguish student, the peaks or the valleys inside, we say this is local or relative maximum. That means this is only maximum or minimum locally in one neighborhood. And later you will see the highest like global or absolute maximum minimum, or we say symbol mark mean this is only the highest or the lowest. So you please distinguish relative maximum or local, relative minimum or local, and you will say this is extremum or plural, this is extrema. So student, local, this is extremum, and global, this is max and min. So now, first question today, let's use derivative to study local or extremum. So I believe that you remember the high school process. When you have to study the extremum of one function, first you take derivative. You let derivative equal zero, you find some bound. And after that, you do one test L. For example, you sketch the table. It's good, but here in fact student, when you move in higher level, we want you to know one thing. These bounds we call critical bounds. And this process tells us that maximum minimum locally can happen only at critical points. But in fact, the critical points is the points where your function R has derivative zero or derivative undefined, does not exist. So now, the first step we want you to spend attention, student. A number belong to domain is critical if either derivative equals zero or derivative does not exist. And this is the first step. After that, we study something else only around critical bounds. So extrema can only happen at critical bounds. This is our picture. If you have derivative equal zero, here you can have relative maximum. Here you will have relative minimum. But sometimes you does not have, but spend attention. If we ask you to find critical bounds, don't forget that at bounds where the derivative does not exist. Anyway, this is critical. For example, like physical bonds of that function. Immediately, I must say student. Wrong answer is like that. You cannot take derivative directly of the absolute sine function. So you must first cancel absolute sine. How? You will have, like high school, absolute sine will be the same inside if this expression greater or equal to zero and minus s when s smaller than zero. So some of you will take derivative. Here this is 1. Here this is minus 1. So you think that this derivative always different from zero. So your answer, the function we study, the absolute sine function, does not have critical bond. But this is wrong answer because you see this is in fact this is the piecewise defined function. The function defined by two formulas. So you spend attention at absolute size student at connection bond s equal zero. So here we have real answer. That function is still s when s greater or equal to 0 minus s when s smaller than 0. So derivative is 1. If s greater than 0, you can see that we escape the connection bond. Here root minus 1 and when s equals 0, the derivative does not exist. In fact, that function gives us the graph of absolute sine. When s greater or equal 0, this is y equals s. When s smaller than 0, this is y equals minus s. So you see, at the left, the slope is minus 1. And at the right, the slope is 1. So your function does not have derivative here because the left derivative and the right derivative, they are different students. So here, because your derivative, in fact, always different from zero, but you have one bond. There, your derivative does not exist. So, student, the critical of that function is f equals zero. I think this example can make some of you scared. Teacher, this is so different from high school. In fact, student, I think in the program, we ask you to spend attention to only one kind of function. This is absolute sine. So that means my real remark, student, if you have function of absolute sine of US, so at the bond where your inside absolute sine function is zero, very, very probably that the derivative there very probably that the derivative there does not exist to that. So remember, I was say only probable because sometimes derivative can exist there, but generally derivative of absolute sine function does not exist when inside equals zero. So remember only that remark. And later, if suddenly you have absolute size function and the question about the critical bonds, don't forget the bond there, the inside is zero. Okay, but if you don't have absolute size, they do normally like high school. So by the first studying, by the first line, I like to warn you this message. But after that, still done. I think the process is simple, like high school, very similar high school. If you want to study the extremum, so play that first step derivative equals zero. So you get S equals C. So C, this is critical number. And you will study the sign of F prime when S passes C. So like high school, if left you have derivative greater than zero, that means increasing function. And after that derivative smaller than zero, so decreasing function. So here clearly your function has local maximum. Here is local minimum. But where derivative always greater than zero, so your function is only increasing or only decreasing, no extrema. So first question will be like high school. The first one, the domain is R, so I need not mention here. Okay, anyway, if you write this good. So there is here, this is 3 x squared minus 6 x. So you have two bonds. And you sketch the graph. You sketch the table more exactly. Inside, this is the second degree, this is the quadratic function. So inside two roots, you know the rule, the derivative, the function will be opposite a, so you have minus. Outside this a plus, so you have increase, decrease, increase. And so you say by that one, s equals zero, your function will have the local max. S equals to local mean. But the second question, very similar third degree function, but here one thing happened, still done. Y prime equals 3 x squared minus 12 x plus 12. So if you start this is zero, you will find only one root. So some of you think, oh teacher, we will have the rule when we have only one root, this is the first degree, so write the same left opposite. So as we have decreasing increasing, so we can say s equal to this a local mean. Tell me your answer, yes or no. Is the second answer, is the second, is the solution for second question, right? Good. Oh, a lot of you say no. Thank you. Here, no, this a, yes, no, this a, right. In fact, even you have only one root, but your expression still second degree. So you cannot use the rule for first degree, the right, same, left, opposite. The thing you must do here is don't stop when you say you can simplify. So this one will be three. If you get three outside, so this is s minus 2 square. So this on y greater or equal 0. The s equal 2 here, this is the repeated root. This not the root, this is not the symbol root. So when s pass the repeated root, the sign of y frame there does not change. So your function is on y increasing. So you don't have s lambda. Okay, this like high school, and even the second question can make some of you make mistake, but I believe that a lot of you take it very, very easily. But now, what happens if I ask you for s lambda of that function? If you take derivative, so sin s this a cos cos s is d minus sin. Okay, this is a difficult equation, but this not really the most difficult. If you print sin there, if you divide, you will have tan equal 1. So you will have the answer pi over 4 plus k pi. I believe that some of you remember this answer. But now, when you have this one, how you find the sine? How you sketch the table like that and find the sine of cos s minus sin s? I must say, define the sine of trigonometric expression. This not easy task for you. So student, if you have difficult function to define the sine of derivative, we will use another derivative test student. Remember, I will return to that example immediately after introduce you this one. If you have see the critical bonds in the meaning derivative equals zero, at that time, please, if the C, if derivative function is not easy to define sine, please add one more derivative, f2 prime, evaluate f2 prime sc. So, if derivative, second derivative greater than zero, so you have relative minimum. If second derivative smaller than zero, so you have relative maximum. Spend attention, if second derivative still zero student, you must add some more derivative. You must do some further analysis. So we don't do it now. That means when the second derivative still zero, we can say the test is inconclusive or non-conclusive. That means you cannot give conclusion. If some of you scare that you forget the sign here, so one simple rule to remember, student. If the second derivative greater than zero, please choose easy function that the second derivative on y greater than zero. Which one? The simplest function, student. This is f equal s square. Do you agree with me? If you take s square, so the first derivative 2s, the second will be 2, so greater than 0. Which that function can tell you, if you have s square, so the graph is upward parabola. And if you have upward parabola, so surely you have minimum. Understand? But if derivative, second derivative, small than zero, if you don't know, if you cannot remember which kind of extremum we have here, teacher, please, that one simple easy function. So derivative, the second derivative on y smaller than zero. Which one? Surely the example is minus s square. Do you agree with me? For that function, You take the first derivative minus 2s. You take one more minus 2 on y smaller than 0. This function has the graph up, downward parabola. And so if you have downward, so you have relative maximum. I repeat student, here the rule is easy. You take the first step, derivative equal zero. You take the second derivative, you will evaluate second derivative at critical point. If this is different from zero number, so you have extrema. Moreover, if the second derivative greater than zero, so you have relative minimum, like elsewhere. If second derivative smaller than zero, so you have relative maximum, like minus elsewhere. But if the second derivative still zero, you can stop there, student. In fact, we can do more, but we don't do that now. So now let's return to the example that I believe that makes some of you uncomfortable, but now we are in position to solve this example. We have d equal r. We take the first derivative, this is 4s minus sin s. Let this zero. So sin equal cos. So you divide, you can see clearly cos here must different from zero. Because if cos s equal zero, so that equation told you sin s equal cos s must be zero too. And sin cos a zero, so sin square plus cos square a zero. This wrong because you know sin square plus cos square on y one. So now cos different from zero, you divide, you will get tan. So s equal pi over 4 plus key pi. But now, how we can continue the second step? We take the next derivative. So derivative of cos this is minus sin. Derivative of sin this is cos. And you will evaluate the second derivative. So you have this is minus sin. And minus cos. Okay, now what happened? Why we stop here? The problem is number k student. K, you know, this is integer number. But can you find this value directly? No, because when you have k pi, you want to true, you want to cancel k pi, but it depends on k is odd or even number. I believe you remember if k here is even, that means 2n. So you can have 2n pi and you will cancel. But if k is different number, odd number, you cannot. So play when you have sin cos and if you have number k pi, k integer, if you want to cancel, you must split your answer into two cases. Case one, case this is 2n. So why to frame their student will be case this is 2n, so you can forget 2n by. You will have minus sin by over 4. Minus cos by over 4. That one is minus square root 2 over 2, square root 2 over 2. So this is minus square root 2. So here you have the pi over 4 plus 2n pi. This is your local or negative maximum. Local maximum still that. But don't stop there. still treat the second k a 2n plus 1. So at that point student, now when you substitute still there, you can see pi over 4 plus 2n plus 1 pi. You multiply and you get 2n pi plus pi. But 2n pi inside sin code lies no wrong, so we can cancel. So you will have inside this a minus sin, but now pi over 4 plus pi, this is 5 pi over 4, and similarly, pi pi over 4, and here still done. This will be minus square root 2 over 2, square root 2 over 2, that minus outside. Inside, you will have one more time, minus square root 2, but minus and minus, you use calculator. You will see this square root 2 greater than 0. So that means at that point where k is odd number, you have local mean. Oh, this is a difficult problem, but we solve perfectly using the second derivative test. So I repeat, student, I don't say that you must worry too much about that kind of example. Rarely, they will appear in the examination like midterm and term. But this technique told you, if you have difficulty to study the sign of F prime, please go to F2 prime. Substitute critical number. And after that, find the size of the expression. This example is difficult because you have trigonometric function. You have k there. So if you want to find the size of sin cos, you must study two cases, even or odd number. But I think for all the exercise, if you can substitute and you find directly the value, the example will be easier for you. Okay? So if you understand, please tell me your opinion, yes or no. If yes, if you understand, and we go to the next topic. If no, anyway, you will go. But you will reward, you will download my recording file to study again. So please tell me your answer. Thank you. You understand, and now we can move to the next topic. Student, this topic, in fact, this very similar F prime, but this not really like F prime, F2 prime. So at 13 March this year, suddenly I hear one declaration, one speech from Mr. Flynn, congressman, USA, or some politician. He said that coronavirus is an inflection point in USA. What is it? Inflection point. Student, one politician said something to all USA citizens, not movement, worker, farmer, seller, and suddenly he said inflation points, and it's not easy to understand. But if you see the graph, the total case coronavirus in the United States, okay, this graph appear everywhere now, you can feel that the moment Lin said is something here, student, and what happened there before the coronavirus case increase slowly. But after that, the coronavirus case increase strongly, student. Do you say you have a difference? So, student, that's why now we will use the second derivative to describe something maybe happen and happen usually in reality. This is inflection point. So originally student, this topic does not belong to program, but anyway, I think in the student book we have, and maybe I don't know when we return, when we study the application. Anyway, you must know this notation. So now I will take easier example student. First, concavity. What is it? Now, let's imagine that one worker student. He comes to factory, he start to work as I am. So you can guess at 9 a.m. He finished, he made 3 items for first hour. At 10 a.m. he made 4 items more. That means totally he made 7. 11 a.m. he made 5 more. 5 plus 7 this is 12. And 12 a.m. he made only 3. So student, you see the number of item. Sometimes we see the output, the number of item that this worker did during the morning shift. It changed. So we know that one like the function with bed time. But if we take that one like accumulated student, the accumulated number of item. So this function will only increase. Do you understand? After first hour, he did 3. So after next hour, I don't know how many items he did, but if we take the sum from the start to surely at 10 a.m., the total number that he did must greater than the total number he did 1 hour ago. Understand? So student, if you sketch the function, the auto accumulated number, here T, here V, from the start of the morning shift, I believe that you have only increasing function. Nothing to say more. But now we want to study another thing. So we try to see closer, clearer to get conclusion. Now you will see the slope student. The slope, let's see the slope of that function. So you know the slope. This is the derivative. And this is also, last week we said, right of change. At the beginning, student, the worker just come into the morning shift. He's still tired. Maybe yesterday he went to bed too late. So he cannot work immediately very fast. So firstly, he works slowly, student. Understand? But as time goes by, now he returned to his habit. He remembered how to control his machine, and he works here faster. Work faster, that means the slope increase. And if the slope increase, student, so the second, the derivative of the slope must. If the slope increase, student, you know the slope is a y prime. And the slope increase, so you take one derivative more. This one, y2 prime must greater than zero. And now he work faster, faster. But can he work faster on time? Like last week we talked about Usain Bolt. First, he runs slow. After that, he runs very fast. But can he always run faster and faster and faster to the end? No student. Somewhere, he tired. So his rate will decrease. You work faster, faster, and you reach somewhere, and after that you feel tired, and you work now slower one more time. Slower, that means the rate decrease, but the rate is y prime. The rate decrease, that means you take one more derivative. So this is negative student. And he cannot work faster as previous. So economically student, we consider the point of diminishing return. That means here, what you must do, you will do the practice. So student, this is the analysis of working right of any worker student. And this analysis one more time told us why we have to have bread at the middle. And here you see the bread must happen where the second derivative change the sign. And that's one we call inflection point, where your second derivative greater than zero student. You have the graph like that. Do you see? So we say up, wow, upward. But when derivative slip negative, so you have the graph like that. So like minus as well. So you will say the graph here is downward. Or we say concave up. Here we say concave down. Student, exactly like S square minus S square. And the bond middle, you will say this is inflation bond, bond of diminishing return. And here, that means when something from faster to slower, or slower to faster, we say this is inflation bond. That's why Mr. Blin said here, the coronavirus hit an inflation point. Before that, increasing very slowly. But after that, increasing really strongly, student. So this is inflation point. So now we give the real definition, but here we don't spend time to each example, student, because it's basic. And we'll do the last example more detail. So now we say the graph is concave upward when the derivative is increasing. That means the second derivative greater than zero student. So remember up. This is the derivative greater than zero. Remember the example, this is square. And down, when derivative negative second order, excuse me, the example is minus s square. So if you have to study the concavity, you will do like increasing, decreasing, but for second derivative, you take first student, tail s pi minus 20 s cube minus the 7, and you take the derivative, so 60 s power 4 minus 60 s square. And you will find three answers. And you will study the sign of second derivative. Okay, You find somewhere positive, somewhere negative. Up positive, you sketch the side like that. Negative, you sketch the side like that. So here, you have upward. Here, you have downward. Concave up, concave down. That's one. Okay, like high school, so I will not spend time there. I like to go more student. An inflection point is a point where your function change the concavity. That means F to frame change the size. At such point, the singularity surely is zero. So student, for such a symbol, if you touch Y frame, so this is 12 T power 5 minus 60 T. Y 2 frame, so 60 T 4, okay, minus 60 T square. You have three rules must pay attention because this is 2 T square. So your function here does not change the size. But here your function change the size. So you have only 2 inflection points. So one more time, this similar high school. The graph is like that, student. When second derivative positive, you have concave up. When negative, you have concave down. Between them, you have inflection point. But I hurry up because I like you to spend attention to that example. The example that we just discussed, student. An efficient study at the morning shift at the factory indicate that worker who start at 8 a.m. will have produced VT. VT is that one. VT unit, VT item, student, T hour later. At what time during the morning is the worker performing most efficiently? That means, student, you must find the time that the worker like Usain Bolt runs fastest, because after this moment, the worker will work slower. Usain Bolt will run slower, so they cannot be the most efficiently after this moment. So for this question, student, in fact, you just do the second derivative test to find the inflection point and let's see the size of we frame there you recognize. So now what we do for this question, that we frame normally minus 3 t square plus 9 18, that's one more. So this is minus 60 plus 18. So we have t equal 3. Now sketch the graph, sketch the table, student. We two frame here equal 0. So because you have the first degree, so the rule you know, right the same. Left opposite. So if the second derivative is here, so that means the derivative like the right increasing, here decreasing. So here, student, you have the right increase. The right increase, student. So that means the worker work faster. But here you have the right degrees, so the work slower. So you see, before, work faster, like run faster, and after that, the worker works slower, like run slower. So here, really, this is the moment where your worker performs his task most efficiently. So because we have T at 3, we start at I. So that means the time we need is 11. So the question is very similar to study the increasing decreasing function student. But instead of your function increase decrease, now you study the increasing decreasing of derivative, the first derivative student. So you must use the second derivative. Understand? So I think this question is interesting from AM. If we have that function, so you must have at this prep at 11 a.m. Okay, so this is long, but I hope that you understand the discussion. So play one more time. What? Send message. Yes, no, to me. To check whether you understand. Maybe so, because later you have time to rewatch before we go to the second, to the last topic. Thank you. Now, let's discuss the last topic today, student. The mismatch of one function. This one is very similar to the extrema, but when we talk about the mismatch student, in fact, we don't talk about the local, we talk about the global or absolute. Minimum, maximum. And by that student, especially when mismatch belong in one interval, we will have some modification in the process. Like extremum, we just that derivative, we let derivative equal zero, we find critical bond, but after that, we don't sketch the table. We don't touch the second derivative. We evaluate the value of function at critical and at two boundaries. And the largest between them is maximum. The smallest is minimum. I believe that you remember that one. So if we remember this rule, so the problem even for difficult function now is easier, much easier. So the answer I recall fast, I believe that some of you see already. First, that derivative. And you know you have the answer. But now because we are interested only the interval 0 by, so you must the integer k, so that critical points belong to 0 by. By that we have k equal 0. So you have only 1 point pi over 4. And now you can check y pi over 4. Y 0, y pi. Y pi over 4 is root square root 2. Y 0 sin 0 plus cos 0. This is 1. Y pi sin pi plus cos pi. This is minus 1. So you have the max and the min. Easy. Sometimes student, we give you the long test, but the mathematics content here very simple, like the Stewart ensemble from the session 4.1. The Hubble Space Telescope was deployed on that day by the space shuttle discovery. The velocity of the shuttle during this mission from lift-off until that moment is given by that function. We ask you to find the mass and the mean value of the acceleration. Understand when, more exactly, the when and after that the value when the shuttle is accelerated most and when the shuttle is accelerated less. So that question is not difficult, so we don't spend time for this one. We just spend attention. We ask you for the acceleration. So you must find it equal v prime t. And this is the third degree. So when you take derivative, you will have the second degree. So you find I prime equal zero, you have one answer, first degree, and you find the I S zero here, I of 1 to 6, and with acceleration at this moment, and by that you find the min max requested. Okay, this basic, the test is long, but on detail are given, the function to boundaries, just spend attention that we ask you for acceleration. The full answer you can read here. But now, I like you to spend attention to the last example. More practical, when the function is not given, you must find yourself. It's absolutely similar, student, to the rate of change problem, to the related rate problem last week. If you have the function, the problem is easy. But if you don't have the main equation, you must find itself. So you feel uncomfortable. So now, let's do that by the last one. This is the practical example. Interesting, but important, but difficult. Exactly like related change. Student, a computer store has selling 200 DVD burner a week at this price. A market survey indicates that for each 10 USD of sale up, the number of units sold will increase by 20 a week. How much a sale up should the store offer to maximize its revenue? So the computer store usually sells DVD burner, and at that price, the store can sell at that price, 350, the store can sell 200. But now, maybe they want to clear, they want to make clearance of this product, so they will sell off, and they say it's time when they decrease the price by 10 USD, the number will increase by 20. Anyway, they cannot decrease the price to, for example, zero because they will lose. So now the question, very clear question, student, how much the store should offer the sale of? So the revenue maximize. Ha. We decrease the price. We increase the number. But you cannot decrease the price so much. So by that question, one more time, I repeat the process still done. If you have difficulty to start, so let's see the question. How much the sale of should the store offer? So that means first step, student, you must not USD. Biết gì? Sell off. Step 1, what is the basic variable? Focus to the question. So, you not student. SUSD. Tell. So the price before this is 350. Now you sell up S, so you will have 300 minus S student. And at that price, you will have the new quantity. This will be 200 plus something else. And if you have the price for each DVD, if you have the quantity that the store sell, you can find the revenue. The revenue will be the price multiplied quantity student. And after that, you will find the maximum of that function. So I repeat student. I will give you the detail to solve now, but the main step student. This is the most important. You find the question. What we ask you, you know the basic, the main variable by S, and you start on your solution by that one. You express the value. What we ask you, the revenue, you find the revenue function, and finally, mathematics come lastly, but we'll give you the answer. So now, like the relative rise, let's solve this problem. I think I will give you the, I will repeat the step we already discussed, and I give you the main discussion here and the final calculation. Please do that yourself. So now, one more time, let not S USD sell up. So this sell up will give you the price for each DVD minus S. So the revenue function will be the price multiply the quantity student. Now what is the main point here? Right, we have how you can find quantity. Here we use one high school but very important discussion. This is proportional. Proportionality student. Let's say student, if the sale up, that means the price decrease by 10. So the number of unit sold will increase by 20. So that means what happens if the sale of 20 students? How about the increasing of the number that the store sold? Can you tell me? Sale of 10. So the sold will increase by 20. So now if the sale of 20, how about the sold increase by how much? Can you tell me the number? Exactly, you found 40. Very right. So that means if you have here this is 30, so this will be 60. We have some proportional here. But now we can have directly, but okay, I think we will write the final answer. So now If we have sale of SUSD, how about the increasing? You will tax because proportionality with that S multiply 10T over 10. Understand? Or here, student, if you don't remember that, you can use even same layer because sell up 10, so increase in 20. So if you divide by 10, you will have sell up 1. So the zone will increase 2. And by that, you have, we have if this is S, so this must be 2S. In fact, this is 2S student. So now you have the revenue function. This will be the price. Multiply the quantity, but the quantity spend the last attention before at that price you sell the store zone 200. So now with that sell up, the zone increase by 2s. So this not 2s here, but this is 200 plus 2s. And you must find the maximum of that function. Where s, okay, you put condition student, you can have s first greater than zero, and surely the revenue must be positive. So you that s smaller or equal 250. In fact, you can imagine now if you sell up 351 for the sample, that means the price is negative, which revenue the store must have zero. Understand? And the last thing, I think anyway, one detail to spend their student, you multiply, you can cancel. So you have the question there, this is minus 2s square plus how much? You will have 2 multiply 350. This is 700 minus 20. So you have 50. So to find the maximum, you take derivative. This is minus 4s plus that one. So s will be this number. You can find the value. And you will say there, your function will have maximum. But the answer, okay, thank you. I made mistake, student. I think that they ask you about the price, but in fact, they ask you about the sale of. So this is already the final answer. I repeat why I said that I made mistake. I like to touch the 350 minus 125. I think that the question, how much the store should sell the duty burner to maximize the revenue, but in fact, how much a sell up should the store offer? So they ask you directly for the sell up. So you give the answer 120. Fine. Okay, do you understand? So, I hope that you understand our discussion.